Okay, so now that we've got our list grid switcher in place, it's time to add some custom order by settings here. Now we are, as you can guess, going back to our layout here. And let's just go to the visual view, even though we can't always see things the way we would like. Isn't that kind of true in life? But we are going to do it the way that we know how to do it. So let's go and add a new module. Now you can type in order by, and you'll see the ARP order by come up. Or as you know, you can just browse to it by going to BodyCommerce, but I'm just going to do it this way this time. And here you can add some order by options. Now you can go ahead and select which side you want it to be on. We're going to have it on the left since we've got our list grid switcher on the right, on the front end, not here, but you get what I mean. Cool. So let's add an item. So the first thing we want to look at is all these different options. Now you can add some ACF custom fields in here that you can put in there. So these might be things like, I don't know, maybe you're selling cars. So maybe you want to add miles to them, right? How many miles does a car have? You can go ahead and add things like square footage if you're selling houses, all sorts of different stuff that you can do the order by. Now, I'm just going to show you these basic ones because they work pretty much exactly the same as those ACF ones would do. So let's go ahead and just put in something like price, and we'll just say pricing. Now, the one thing you want to do here is also just identify whether it's going to be numeric or alphanumeric, because that affects the way that it sorts it. So this is, of course, numeric since we're dealing with price, and you can say price, and we're going to go with high. Now, you might have seen this on Amazon, so it'll sort it by the highest price first because it's going to descend. And then we'll add another one for descending. So let's go ahead and add pricing low. And we will select price again. And this time it's going to ascend from the top, from the lowest one to the main top one. Okay. So here we also have some styling options. So you can do all sorts of stuff here. I'm not going to get into this because this is really something that you can go through and do yourself. And you have some localized ones within each of those, because what might happen is that you might have like different types of fields in there if you're working with ACF, that type of stuff. So that is why you might want to come in here and style something like a checkbox or button style or something like that. We're not getting into that here. That's for you to explore with our documentation or just playing. That's the best way to learn. Play. Okay. Now, this would have added this to the bottom. Now, that's beautiful, but that, of course, does not look like anything Divi related. That's just because it's not visual builder compatible. You'll hear me say that quite a bit. So I'm just going to pull this guy up and just drop it at the top, because otherwise it would have put it beneath the loop, and I don't think that's the most effective way. So let's go ahead and update this. And let's hop on the front end and hit that old refresh button. Okay, so now what you're going to want to do here is use your magic with positioning. We're not getting into that right now, but here we can go and we'll say low. And it's got the lowest price and it kind of steps up as it goes. And then we can go and select high. And it'll have the highest prices stepping down. So that is adding custom sort by options to your pages. Now, sometimes people have these above the list grid switcher. They have them in different spots. Maybe they have them by the filters. We're going to get into adding some filters a little bit later in the course. But just wanted to show you guys how easy it is to be very hyper granular about how you allow users to browse your store. So let's keep moving on, because in the next part, we're going to be covering those custom loop layouts. See you there.